G'day guys, Deadman here again. Today is going to be a slight talk on what I'm hoping to achieve, obviously before upgrading to a different system. The VXL3S system is decent, really. I've seen, you can correct me if I'm wrong, but I've seen Lightning Dad hit 87 miles per hour, I believe, with the stock Lenin system. James Spec hit 83.3 miles per hour, and recently Central Texas RC hit 81.2, I think it was. So I'm hoping to beat that. And I'm pretty sure I can do it. It's mainly, with any car, it's the way it's set up and gearing, obviously. Now I've been told that I need to run it a couple of times, obviously, and then check the temperatures. Now, my hands aren't the best for checking temperatures. I'm a baker by trade. That's what I did before my life changed. So, temperatures aren't really good when you're touching things coming out of an oven at 240 degrees. It's you don't have as much sensitivity. So it may be hotter than what I can feel it at. So I'm going to need to get a temperature sensor or gun. You know, one of those little infrared thermometer things I've seen some people use to check the motor temperature and obviously the EC temperature. I've removed the wheels off the back of this, which I was told to do before I ran it last weekend. When I first showed people which wheelie bar I was going to be getting, and or that I was going to get a wheelie bar, they said either get just a flat bit of metal to come out the back to so that it will hit the ground and bounce back up instead of wheeling, basically. And I didn't listen and I left the wheels on. Last week I ran it and we did a backflip. When it decided to come off the ground, which it only did once. You come up, hit the wheels, as you can see, maybe you can't see from there, but, it scuffed the wheels only a little bit, they're not, mainly scuffed there, so I'd say that's where it hit, and then it got lighter, basically because it was, flipping. So, I guess I could probably use a rubber wheel, but I'm not going to worry about it for now. I left the bracket on that holds them. I just turned them around, and hopefully that'll stop the actual thing from getting damaged. Otherwise, I could probably get a bit of an old tire, like the sidewall, or even one of these that run pretty flat, cut out a piece and put it there so that we don't damage a nice shiny metal if we do it. It bothers me a little bit, to be honest, but it won't bother me that much. It's not breaking it, it's just giving it character, so to speak. So last weekend I hit 99 kilometers an hour, which is good because I'm a little bit away from 100. In the translation for you American people, that's approximately 60 miles an hour. So after we get over 100, I then want to get over 114, obviously. That's 70 miles an hour. Then I think the next marker for 87-ish is about 140 miles per hour. Now, with the gearing that they were using, I think some of them were either using 32 pitch or some of them, I mean, I think it was Central Texas and James Beck. I could be wrong, they could correct me. Obviously, they're not going to tell me exactly what gearing they were using, but I think they were using 32B gearing or Mod 1 gears already. So, now what I believe makes it stock isn't anything to do with the wheels, axle, like anything to do with the frame of the car. It's just the ESC and motor and running it on an actual 3S battery, obviously. The if you have a look at some of the runs from the Central Texas 3S Challenge, the part of the ruling was that they were able to link them in, I think they call it linking it in series, so you could have two 3S batteries, which to me is 6S, and yeah, so that's it. So I'll only be using 3S. It'll probably, oh, bleh. I probably will change the battery, as in what battery I'm actually running somewhere down the line. But essentially, these two are the main components. So when we check our temperatures, we should get an idea as to how much further I can push it in terms of gearing. The car ran fairly straight last weekend. It was a little shaky to start with, but once it started actually going, it was fine. I really didn't have to steer it all that much. And to, I've forgotten your name. One sec. George SJ1979, in one of his video last week, said that the reason that his car was going all over the place was because he didn't have Traxxas stability management or a gyro. Don't think many people run them on their cars anymore. Maybe the standard Traxxas thing, but I don't think people are running the gyros anymore. I could be wrong. But I mean, neither am I. I need to drive my car the same as you. I think I've got a slight benefit that these tyres are already running, and yours are not. So they're going to be a bit more slippery, and I have seen them be fairly slippery. I'm talking about the GRPs that have the tread on them, not the slicks. So yeah, that's what I'm hoping to do, is to make it as fast as possible. And I do believe I have a way of doing that, and keeping it at 48p gearing. Whether people are going to agree with me as to how I get it done is yet to be seen. Because obviously I will discuss it with a couple of people, just to see if there's any upgrades I need to do to ensure the safety of the motor and the ESC and not go up in a ball of flame. Now, so I've also got, as you can see, these shocks. They are the Nitro Revo shocks, I believe. And I want to thank Mark from Brad Mark's RC Garage for helping me with getting, I think it was these ones, the front ones, getting the little eyelets off. Unfortunately, I don't have the tools or the strength to be able to get it done. And he helped me. He took them home, got them off, and got them back to me. He also had an extra securing nut for the GRPs, sorry, for the 17mm adapters from an XL1, that I was, which is the little black bit that goes in the middle, because one of my wheels come off. I said, drive it till the wheels come off, and that's exactly what I did last weekend. One of the wheels come off, and I couldn't find the little bit. So we've got everything fixed, ready to go for more runs. I'm waiting on hardware to be able to fit these, which will hopefully be here next week. The guy's giving me the shits at the moment. So we should be able to fit them next week, but the video may not be out until the week after, because I'm hoping to do a few runs. And with this setup, sorry, because it was running fine. So if it's running straight, I don't want to mess with it just yet. I'm pretty sure I need to bend this down a bit more. If you can suggest a way of doing it. I know people have done it in the past, but I just don't know how to get it bent. Apart from running it into a brick wall. but yeah, so if you can suggest a way of getting it bent further down. It is installed upside down if you pay attention in the video. Other things, in the description you'll see an address, not my personal address, it's a parcel locker address. If you have old parts lying around and you wish to help, and or you can afford to help, if you don't, like me, and don't have any monies, please do not waste your money on me. Pay your bills and shit. By all means, feel free to send me things that are collecting dust or anything that you think I'll be able to use. And there will also be a PayPal link. If you have some spare change, any money that goes into PayPal goes directly on my card. Was there anything else? I don't think so. Ah, yes. Apart from breaking the car, is the only way this plan is going to stuff up. I am looking into getting tools to assist me in working on it a bit easier. And also, my table's going to be moved in the next week or so. Because it'll be better light, I think, where I'm putting it. I think, maybe. If not, I'll get a light for it. So, just a cheap battery-powered drill that'll help me get the things out a bit quicker. So I'm not sitting upright for any longer than necessary. And other tools that may come in handy with setting up the car. I think I still have some from my Nitro car, but basically all I've got at the moment are what you've seen me use, just little old bits and pieces that I've had lying around from when I was working on my Gemini. So I want to talk about what I want to do with the channel in general. Obviously get this as fast as it can go, period. That's I like going fast, and breaking things is all part of that. It's part of the journey, it's part of the process, it's part of RC in general. Things break, shit happens. I actually start laughing when things start falling off my car, or when I hit the gutter or anything like that. But anyway, that's just me. I guess I'm a little, I think the word's narcissistic. You can correct me on that too if you want. Use of words aren't very good for me. But channel. I do like bashing. That's generally what I do. Because it's fun. You go off a jump, you may not land correctly. But racing, that's not for me. I'm not good with directional Especially when it gets flipped around, like the car will turn. Therefore, the perception of where, not where the car is, but like where left and right are can change in your mind, or my brain tries to flip it around and it shouldn't be, or whatever the case may be. But yeah, so once this car's done, we should have enough parts for another car, basically. Because we still need to change our A-arms, we need to change our drive shafts to take more power, we've got the shocks there to be changed, we need to change this to an alloy box. And just because blue, change these to the blue ones, and I think they're stronger too. Change them to the blue ones, get these and these, definitely these first. But this is just about wound out as far as it can be. I'll point it out on this side as well, just in case you can't see it. It's the tow control and steering, what connects to your steering bell crank, which again we need to change. We need to change the bulkhead, but all that comes in, not the yellow ones. A few kits I've seen on eBay of the chassis. You can get the lowest chassis kit and a top chassis kit, and the bulkhead comes with it, so that's not too much of a problem. But what I'm going to build in order to bash with, I don't know whether I want to go with building Rustler, because, well, hey, we've got one. So I'm thinking either slash, two-wheel drive slash, or I think the Dark Ecliptic Heart called it a Bantler. Basically, you build a Rustler and you put your banded body on it. That could be fun, or a Stampede, but I'm very leaning towards the Slash. Just maybe use some bigger wheels than what a Slash uses as a short course truck. So yeah, that's what I'm hoping to do. So that's where the parts donation and stuff like that comes into it. I want more cars and I want to build them and have fun with the hobby, basically. But upgrading this for me is going to be the number one priority, and also the number one expense. That's why I need to get tools to help me be able to do things more efficiently and be able to do different things too. So, thanks for watching again, and sorry I took up so much of your time this week. Have a good one.